A cool evening to one and all. This is Pujita Nalla of Grade 10. I welcome you all to the Paramita Tethered event. Today, I'm here to share one of the beautiful life hacks. Our life is full of emotions. We experience a lot of emotions like happiness, anger, dejection, excitement, and many more. And different people react to different situations in different ways. But no one can expect the consequences of that reaction. So it's not about the situation or the circumstance, it's about you in it. I repeat it, it's not about the situation or the circumstance, it's about you in it. Today, by the end of my presentation, you'll come to know the difference between response and reaction and the way to respond. First, let me start my talk by explaining the difference between response and reaction with an example. One day, a girl was playing cricket and the ball suddenly hit the window of their house and the glass was broken. Her mother observed it and scolded her in anger. This is called the reaction which hurt the feelings of child. So I hope reacting in such a way to the above situation is not correct. So let me explain you how to deal the same situation in another way. First, the mother has to check if her child is okay. Is she hurt or is she scared? Second, the mother has to realize that the broken object is not that important than her child. Third, the mother has to make her child realize her mistake and make her not repeat the same. This is called the response. So I hope you have understood the difference between response and reaction. So we need to respond, no need to react. Now, when people criticize and sledge you in the game of life, will you be cool or do you react? There will always be people who criticize you. Can you stop people from criticizing you? You can just do nothing. These are called the things which are out of control. So now, let me share an incident with you. One day, both wife and husband had a great fight and wife called her mother and said, "Mama, we had a fight and I just don't want to stay with my husband. I'm going to come to stay with you for 2 weeks. Then mother replied, "Oh my dear, why you should come to my home? Let your husband face the consequences of his deeds." Then mother said that, "I will be only coming to your home and staying with both of you for 2 weeks. So I think you can just understand the tone of mother-in-law, and I think you can just imagine now the consequences the husband is going to face. So friends, you just please think before you leave. Now, our life consists of different results, that is failure and success. We have to treat this both failure and success equally. Tom Watson, sir, said, "If you want to succeed, double your failure rate." So failures are the stepping stones of success. Our mind must be programmed for enjoying the success and handling the failure. You must remember one thing, that our life is just like the keys on the piano. Sometimes white keys are pressed and sometimes black ones take the lead. And sometimes both create symphony. Same is the case of our life. Sometimes we experience happiness and sometimes sorrowfulness. And sometimes our happiness makes us to react but not respond. For instance, if I get the best GPA, I may be very, very happy. But the sad thing is that I may start looking down my friends who got low GPA. As a result, I may feel that I'm superior to them. And this clouds my wisdom. So how should I react in the above situation? First, I must remain humble. If it is a happy situation, I have to pay gratitude to the people who made me happy and I have to make others happy. Now, we must remember one thing, that happiness and sorrowfulness are like spring and autumn. The balance between these two makes our life beautiful and purposeful. Do you know that the most dangerous reaction in this world is growing anger? We may be angry for simple things and become frustrated, and we may show this frustration on others which hurt their feelings. So let me tell you some tips to control your anger. First, you must calm down and repeat some phrases like take it easy, cool off, or anything that works, or speak to your favorite person, or think of a joke or a positive situation, or count till 10 to 50 or till you get cooled down, or splash some cold water on your head. I hope you use these tips, and I'm sure that by using these tips, you can get rid of your anger. Now, reactions are the offsprings of disturbances. If the disturbances are handled properly, then the offsprings become responses but not reactions. I repeat it, reactions are the offsprings of disturbances. If the disturbances are handled properly, then the offsprings become responses but not reactions. In this context, let me narrate a story which I have read. There was a small party in a restaurant. It was filled with good-looking, luxurious men and women. Suddenly, a cockroach flew into the room and settled on the hand of a lady. That lady screamed hysterically and started to jump. Then it settled on the hand of another lady. She too did the same. The whole area was filled with screams and plates fell off the tables. At last, it settled on the hand of a waiter. The waiter stood motionless. He observed the behavior of cockroach. He grabbed and threw it out of the room. Here, it's not about the cockroach. It's the inability of women to handle the disturbance created by the cockroach. So it's not the toughness of my subjects like maths, physics, and chemistry. It's my inability to handle the toughness of the subjects. Moreover, it's my reactions to the toughness which makes me fearful. In the above story, woman reacted, but the waiter responded. So reactions are always thoughtless, but responses are always intellectual. I repeat it, reactions are always thoughtless, but responses are always intellectual. So we shall respond with responsibilities because we are born to be happy and make others happy. Thank you.